Good morning, dear students. Welcome back to our lesson that is fundamental unit of life. Okay, and my last session, in the previous session, I explained you about the important cell organelle. Actually, all the cell organelles. What I gave you the example for the cell organelles. What I say, I resemble cell organelles to what? Workers, okay, and all workers into the factory are important, okay. So last time we have gone for the two cell organelles, which are two workers, right, of the cell, of the manager, of the CEO. Those two cell organelles were what? The ribosome and endoplasmic reticulum, okay. So endoplasmic reticulum and ribosome I have already completed, which is the important part of the cytoplasm. Now we will move ahead with the another cell organelle, which is also too much important. Rather, this is too much important. Why it is important? That secret I shall very soon disclose to you all, okay. So we are going to talk about one important cell organelle, that is called what? Mitochondria. Okay, what is mitochondria? If I would ask you this question is not correct. Why, student? Because mitochondria is the plural form, right? Mitochondria is the plural form. Then what is the singular form of the mitochondria? The singular form of the mitochondria is mitochondrion. What is mitochondrion? Okay, mitochondrion. So in this today's session, we are going to talk about the another important cell organelle. The name is what? What is mitochondrion? In singular, it is called as mitochondrion, and plural, it is called as a mitochondria. Okay, now what is this mitochondria? How the structure is designed, that we will see. See, I shall draw for you a figure. This is what? Outer membrane of the mitochondria. And this is what? The inner membrane of the mitochondria. Inner membrane of the mitochondria. Okay. So, we can say that this mitochondria will also have two membranes. Okay. The outer membrane is plain membrane. Okay. And it has a small, small pores on it. What is the function of the pores? That I shall let you know very soon. Okay. So, it has a small, small pores on the outer membrane of the mitochondria, okay. And if we will talk about the inner membrane of the mitochondria, then you can see a lot of folds on the inner membrane of the mitochondria, okay. This lot of folds, these are designed to increase the surface area for the absorption of the material which is needed for the functioning of the mitochondria. Now, what function mitochondria is performing, that we will see. But you should know why the outer membrane, of the mitochondria is porous, because this outer membrane is selectively permeable membrane. Okay, this is selectively permeable membrane. It is allowing the entry and exit of only particular material, and that material, whatever material is needed for the mitochondria, it will enter through this small, small pores. Okay, and the material which is not needed for the mitochondria, that material will go out from this pore. Okay, so I hope it is clear for you that the structure of the mitochondria, into the structure of the mitochondria, there are two membranes. The outer membrane has a pore to allow the entry and exit of only particular material. If we will have a closer look inside, then you can see it has a lot of folds. Okay, for this membrane, many folds are there. These folds are designed to increase the surface area. To increase surface area. I hope it is also clear for you. Outer membrane is porous, while inner membrane has a lot of folds on it to increase the surface area. Okay. Now, student, what is present in it? Okay, we will see what is present in it and
thing. One more thing, in the structure it would come that these folds are called as what? Christie. These folds are called as what? Christie. Keep in mind, students, the outer membrane is porous and the inner membrane, which has a finger-like projection. Finger-like projection means the inner structure of this mitochondria has a finger-like projection. That is for what? To increase the surface area. And those folds are called as what? Christie. So, I hope the diagram and the structure is clear for you. Now, if we will talk about the function of it, and one more thing, it contains its own ribosome and DNA. I say you the function of the ribosome. Ribosome is designed into the cell, because ribosomes are called as what? Protein factory. Ribosomes are created, are producing protein which is needed for the cell. So, this is the structure which has its own ribosomes. So, requirement of the protein is getting fulfilled by only of itself. So, this mitochondria structure is called as what? Autonomous. Autonomous structure. Autonomous, there are three terms, students. Dependent, right? The small child is completely dependent on the mother, okay? Then your eight children are not completely dependent on the mother, right? Partially you are dependent on the mother, not completely. The smaller child is completely dependent on the mother, right? For susu, for potty, everything. But you are not dependent in that way. You are dependent, but not in that way. So you are said to be semi-autonomous. While this cell organelle, and autonomous means what? Not at all dependent, like your parents or myself. We are not dependent on our parents now, because we are independent, we can fulfill our demands of our own. So I hope this concept is clear of the dependent, semi-autonomous and autonomous. So this is not dependent on anyone. It comes into the semi-autonomous, okay? Why? Because it has its own DNA and ribosome. Okay, whenever it want to be replicate, means suppose if you have various mitochondria into the cytoplasm, then that mitochondria will give rise to another mitochondria. Means mitochondria replication, one mitochondria will give to another mitochondria, another mitochondria will give to another mitochondria. That is possible because of what? Because it has its own DNA material. Understood, students? So it is called as the autonomous, because it is not dependent on any other particles of the cell. So this is called as the autonomous, because it can replicate. The mitochondrial replication can be taken place by its own, because it contains its own DNA material. Okay. At the same time, it has also presents ribosome, and ribosomes are the protein factory of the cell. So whatever protein is needed for this mitochondria, that protein can be taken by the ribosome. So these two terms I wanted to clear with you, and that is clear that it has its own DNA material and it has its own ribosome, which is performing their role for the functioning of the mitochondria. Okay. Now, if you will go ahead, then this is the mitochondria, and this mitochondria is taking place into the respiration. Okay. Respiration means what, student? Whatever the food we eat, that food we convert into the nutrients, okay? Water soluble nutrients. Those water soluble nutrients are further breaking down, okay? Those water soluble nutrients, those food particles are breaking down in presence of what? Oxygen. In presence of what? Oxygen. So through this small pore, the oxygen is entering inside, okay? Oxygen is entering inside for what? For breaking down of the food material in presence of oxygen, okay, and that is called as what? Respiration process. Okay, respiration process is needed to give us energy, and that energy is stored into the mitochondria in the form of ATP. Okay, so that this mitochondria is called as what? Powerhouse of the cell. It is called as what? Powerhouse of the cell. I repeat, what it does, it is allowing the entry of oxygen into the inner membrane of the mitochondria, which is called as a Christie. Here what happens, the nutrients are there in our body. Those nutrients are breaking down in presence of oxygen. As it is taking place in presence of oxygen, it is called as what? Aerobic respiration. And the result of the aerobic respiration is what? Energy. And that energy is stored into the mitochondria in the form of what? ATP. Okay, I should rub this now. I hope you understand this structure. So, I'll go ahead. See here, into the mitochondria, respiration is taking place. It's the site of the respiration. Okay? And this respiration is called as what? Metabolic process. Metabolic process means what? Chemical process. So, various chemical processes are taking place into the mitochondria. Out of that, one important chemical metabolic process is respiration, breaking down of food or nutrient in presence of oxygen is called as what? Aerobic respiration, and that is carried out into the pristi of the mitochondria. Aerobic respiration gives rise to ATP. Means what, student? See, I need energy, right? I need energy for my physical work as well as I need energy for my other life processes. That energy I can get by this energy, because wherever the energy is present, we are taking, or it is also called as a battery of the cell also, we can say, right? Battery of the cell. See, if now I am exhausted, if I will drink one cup of coffee, I will feel very energetic. Why? Because I have eaten something. Or if you will add some fuel in your car, in your vehicle, the car can run very fast. Likewise, this ATP is the energy currency of the cell. Okay? Because energy which is produced by the mitochondria, by the process of respiration, is stored into the ATP. Okay? And it is stored into the mitochondria in the form of ATP. I shall draw the structure for you, ATP. See, there are three phosphate molecules. Okay? These three phosphate molecules are there and which are attached to this adenosine, ATP. What is the... This is what? Phosphate. And this is what? Adenosine ring. Adenosine. So, what is the long form for the ATP? Adenosine triphosphate. Adenosine triphosphate. Because one molecule of phosphate means three atoms of the phosphate. So, this is called as what? Adenosine triphosphate. And this ATP is called as what? Energy currency of the body. Means whenever we need energy, we will go to ATP, we will get that energy, we will take that energy and we will use it. Understood? And that energy is produced by the process of respiration. Okay? Respiration process will give us energy, and that is stored into the mitochondria of a cell in the form of ATP. So, mitochondria is called as what? Powerhouse of the cell. And ATP is called as a energy currency of the body. Okay, so this is the chemical, anabolic, catabolic, metabolic process is taking place into the mitochondria. So, I hope the part of the mitochondria is clear for you. Thank you so much.